everyone, we're just going to wait about 2 minutes to make sure that all the folks that are tuning on the live stream have gotten their setup ready, and then we'll begin. All right, good evening, everyone. My name is Krista McBride, and I'm the band teacher here at Centennial Collegiate. I am incredibly thrilled to have a live performance. It has been, I think, 732 days since we have performed, and I couldn't be more thrilled. These folks in front of you are the Grade 9 Band, of course. Welcome to Grade 9 Family and Friends, as well as Grade 9 Family and Friends on the live stream. We thank you for taking time out of your day to support these wonderful musicians who played for about a year and a half, and then they took a year and a half off. But they joined us here, and we've been working really hard for the last couple of months. So I'm thrilled to show you what they've accomplished and what they've done together. So welcome to our concert, and I'm going to pass the microphone over to Nico, who will introduce our first piece.
The first song we'll be playing for y'all today is composed by Brian Balmages. He's an award-winning composer and conductor. His music has been performed all over the world. The Scottish Festival is based on the popular Scottish folk song, Aiken Drum. This piece is supposed to mimic all the parts of a bagpipe. Here is a Scottish Festival. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Our next piece will be introduced by Sam.
This next piece we have prepared for tonight was composed by Mr. Jack Wilde. It was composed as a tribute to early 20th century dance pieces, and we begin it as school bands just like us in mind. A lyrical and adrenaline-filled piece highlighted by its contrasting dynamics and carefully placed articulations. Here stands Lev.
Thank you. Welcome, everyone. It's so nice to see so many people out. Welcome to the folks who are on the live stream as well from home. My name is Krista McBride, and if we haven't had a chance to meet, I'm glad you're here tonight, and that you get to see these fabulous folks behind me. The grade 10s have not had a chance to perform live for anyone since they came to Centennial. In fact, it's been 732 days since we performed live in this building, so I'm thrilled that you're here tonight. I'm so excited, and I couldn't be more proud of the students behind me. So there's that. We have three selections for you tonight, and the first one will be introduced by Maureen.
Welcome and good evening. My name is Maureen, and I'm a flute player in our wonderful grade 10 band. Our first song will be The Steps of Russia. This is an exciting and mostly fast-paced song based on a Russian folk dance and was composed by Elliot Dobrovo. Thank you for coming, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
reason for this particular group. There is a strong low string section in here, and that gave them the opportunity to have the melody a few times. So it was specifically chosen just for that. The next two will be introduced by Brooke.
The next song we are playing this evening is called The Rowan Tree, set by Randall D. Standridge. The Rowan Tree is a beautiful yet simple old Scottish folk song. The song was originally written by Lady Nairn in the early 1800s. The lyrics were written by Carolina Oliphant, talk about a beautiful tree abundant with bright orange berries found on the hills of Scotland. We invite you to enjoy this heartfelt rendition of The Rowan Tree.
Thank you. introduces the piece. Again, let me say how proud I am of the group in front of us right now. All year last year with no public performance, and a really, really great group of students who want to do well as a group. And everybody seems to pull their own weight really, really well, and just a great nice kids. So that's on you folks. So thank you for all the support that you give these folks. It shows.
Polar Express was a movie directed by Robert Zemeckis and Zemeckis. This was a Christmas movie planned on Christmas Eve when the cowboys embarked on an adventure to the North Pole on the Polar Express. On the way, learning about bravery and the spirit of Christmas, this song was written by Paul Avenger. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
very much. Have a seat. We are going to do our next audience shift. It's jazz band up next, so if you are a jazz band audience member, you can stay. Otherwise, we're going to get our audience out this way, so you can head out this door. You folks, we're out these two doors, like in practice, and we'll bring on the jazz band. Okay, so, looks like. Thank you. we've got the junior jazz band in front of us. This is made up of students from grade 9 and 10. We rehearse for, I don't know what, 25 minutes a week maybe, by the time we meet here at lunch and whatnot, and, you know, get organized and all these different instruments and that get together. What is so great about these students is, A, that they're here. I just said, hey, folks, junior jazz, who's coming? And all these folks showed up. So that's the best part. The second best part, again, is that they're just lovely people. So lots of good mixing between grade 9 and 10s, and that always makes me happy. We've got one tune for you tonight. It's called Beantown Blues Parade. And if you are thinking kind of New Orleans and maybe what you might hear from a band walking down the street in a parade, you've got this song. So it does have a feature for our trombones and baritones and horn in the middle row. And then later on, you'll hear our trumpet section. So this is the junior jazz band here from Centennial, and we've got Beantown Blues Parade for you.
Thank you.
Marcus as well.
Our arrangement by Peter Blair. Autumn Leaves is what we call a jazz standard.
It was originally written in the lyrics in French and then translated into something that worked for English as well. I believe it was a number one hit in 1955, if I'm not mistaken. But here we go, on these. Solos, right? We have the soli section from the saxophones. Yeah, soli section from the saxophones, and we have a piano solo from John Mann. Thank you. Okay, we've got one more tune with the senior jazz band. Oh, and all the brass players go to empty visual belt. Maybe you need some space, folks. The last tune we have for you is Birdland, originally made famous in 1977 before any of us were around, I know, and made famous by the band Weather Report. So, yeah, Weather Report, Birdland. Thank you.
Thank you.
well, thank you so much for coming. It's nice to see everyone. I said earlier in the concert, but I know lots of folks weren't here, that it has been, I believe, 732 days since we last played live. And these students were a part of that concert for the most part. So they're kind of our only experienced group tonight, really, as far as playing here at Centennial. So if you haven't met, my name is Kristen McBride, and I'm the band teacher here at Centennial. And it is an absolute pleasure to start my mornings every other day with these folks. You know, I see folks out in the hall, and we're a little tired and that. But it seems that about 9:03, this group wakes up, and we always have a good hour together, and I think lots of fun. So from my perspective, anyway, you have some fine students here. I'm excited to share with you tonight what they've been working on. It takes a little while to put two bands together into a senior band here at Centennial. But this group of people have been so supportive of each other. They celebrate each other's successes. They applaud for people who have been solos. And it's just, it's really heartwarming that they care so much about each other. So thank you, I guess, before you even play, for those things that you do. The first piece is going to be introduced by Julia.
Drum for the Sammies is a mix of traditional native drumming and modern band music. Drum for the Sammies was commissioned by the Medicine Hat Concert Band Society. Enjoy.
orchestral percussionists that are currently moving around quickly to get ready for the next song. It doesn't happen often, I'll be very honest with you, that you have a group of percussionists who all read music well, play musically, and are just excellent people and try to be as musical as they can. And this band really has four superb percussionists. We're extremely lucky to have them, so I'm so glad that that featured them. Our next tune will be Aurora. Hi, I'm Aurora.
Hi.
Okay, so the next song we're going to be playing is called Penny Harbor Bates Gift. It's a popular Newfoundland folk song, Penny Harbor Bates Gift. It's a melancholy tune that has ties to an 1852 tragedy. Cool. And I'm just really hoping that my Googling before the show is correct, because if it's not, that would be awkward. But on June 8, 1852, a Bates Gift sank near the coast of Penny Harbor. Six men lost their lives. However, one young boy was saved by a gentleman named Jacob Chafe. Jacob Chafe was recognized as a hero by the community. Whilst this tale has an air of heroism, the community was greatly affected by the tragedy. To quote the song lyrics, because there are apparently song lyrics, when the sad news arrived next day in dear old St. John's Town, there was a crying and lamenting on the streets both up and down. Their mothers were lamenting, crying for those they bore. On the boisterous waves, they found their graves, where they near shall see more. Penny Harbor Bates Gift is a piece filled with longing and tragedy. Allow yourself to be swept away by this Newfoundland favorite. Listen closely for a soulful euphonium highlight. Enjoy. Thank you. Thank you very much. We have one final selection before we send everyone on their way. Before I do that, I have a few thank yous. Actually, I have a lot of thank yous. I'll probably miss someone, but I'll do my best. First of all, to the students. Without the students, there would be no music in this building. And so thank you, first of all, to you folks. To the parents and the families of the students, I know it's a little bit of extra work, calling the instrument, reminders to practice and whatnot. I so appreciate the support that you show our musicians here, and we certainly couldn't do it without you folks. A concert like this cannot happen with just the students and I. We certainly need some help. Back in the booth, I believe we've got Austin, and I'm not sure who's with Austin, but thank you to the Tech Club and Mr. Dietrich. I know I asked River and Lynn to help out as well. So thank you to those folks for making sure that the lights and our live feed and our microphones work. Also, thank you to all of the staff who volunteered to give up the time tonight to be here with us. I've had a stage crew, I've had ushers, I've had folks at the door. I couldn't do it without your support. So thank you very much for supporting the musicians here at Centennial to those staff members. I probably forgot somebody. I'm really sorry if I did. My last thank you is to the administrators here at Centennial. Anytime I want something for musicians, the answer is always, how can I help or what can I do? So to Ms. Tamlin, Ms. McGarland, and Ms. Benson, thank you for supporting music here. It means the world to me and to these students that we get to do this together with your support. So thank you very much to the administration. Our final tune, Deacon is going to introduce.
So Peter Tchaikovsky wrote the Nutcracker in 1891, and right before it was released, he took 8 of the movements and put them into the Nutcracker sheet. 4 of those movements have been put together in this piece that we're just about to play for you, so please enjoy scenes from the Nutcracker. Thank you.
Appreciated the way that you help us do everything, and I just want to give you a thank you for you. So give me a round of applause.